about someone who's interrupting. Say we're making a fucking movie, okay? Tell me the truth, then Geoffrey and dance going on. And all of a sudden the house lights come on. Intimate dance and dim light. All of a sudden the house lights come on. Someone goes, oops, sorry, from behind the curtains. And the person dancing continues dancing, but shyly. Kind of goes, what the fuck? Come on. What the fuck? Really annoyed. Why did you do that? What the fuck? Got the fucking space right now. But continues trying to do the dance. So the lights come on. After doing this intimate dance again, after being interrupted with the light, keep doing it for a while. Then go on to something else, such as start talking, like reciting poetry, and then be interrupted by Rohan, the worker, coming in. Oh, this stack of chairs. So, where do you want these? I ignore him. Oi. Oi, where are we gonna have the chairs? Oi, where you want the chairs? He just stands looking at me. Spotlight shifts from me to Rohan. He's just looking at me, and I'm still doing this. Poem that quiets down and doing the dance in the dark night, he spotlight. And then from dancing, I go over to Rohan, who's just watching me spotlight. I look over at the spot I was just dancing at for a while. Then I look over. A chair that was behind me. Now the chair is spotlighted. And I say to Rohan something. You know, I wonder if God likes my chairs. I invented these. I thought of them in my head. Yes. Then I drew them on a piece of paper. Then they were manufactured by skilled carpenters. By skilled laborers. Now they are here. Now I say to Rohan, gosh, you know that I invented that chair? This chair. Gosh, you know that I invented this chair? Yes. In my head, I invented it. But the chair, Rohan says to me, but the chair is unstable. Like your thoughts that thought it up. Unstable. I said to Rohan, sit on it. He says, oh no, nope. Not I. I will not sit on your chair. the lighting set up and camera and lights are set up in the corner of the chair. The cheek always back to the audience, shirt off and army pants and scarf around his neck, a cotton scarf, and he's doing that in the spotlight, and the two boys brought in with the trolley with their fists up in the air, revolutionary. They're taken across very close to the audience, and then sharp turn to the back wall, to the center, in front of Lindsay, who's up against the back wall, and they put down their fists up, standing there, the line, their fists in the air.
Our motor areas are either not functioning or they're hyper functioning.
The spot with the camera.
It looks very similar.
Ron sits in the chair and Lindsay's filming him. And next to Lindsay, telling, giving Ron his lines, or rather, Rohan's saying the lines. And I'm repeating them, telling him how to say it. And eventually get really into it, and I burst over to dance while Rohan is still saying the lines, and I'm saying them after him. And the two boys leave together their steps in unison. And they, when nobody's looking, they climb up on top of the stage. The seating bank. And they wait there concealed for a long time. Oh yeah, in front of all of this is Tim Mathiasen sitting there, also kind of doing some kind of breathing exercise, qigong thing, and behind him is porn. Subtitle porn. That's speaking the words that Roman and I let him speak. Thank you.
Addy mode. Addy mode.